this morning from Archer Materials is Dr. Mohammad Choucair. Mohammad, good morning.
Good morning, good to see you.
And you, Mohammad. You've had this technical update out this week on the quantum chips development. Before we talk through it, just give us a quick reminder about quantum computing, what it is, why it's important.
Yeah, quantum computing is an entirely different way of computing, and it's set to impact almost every industry reliant on that ever-increasing need for computational power. But, you know, to do this, it requires new technology to be built. There's really no one quantum computing chip to rule them all, right? And it's important to know that Archer is only one of very few companies globally that is building a quantum computing processor chip. And what's unique about our 1-2-CQ chip is that when built, it could turn existing devices into quantum powered devices.
Well, just to build on that, you mentioned computational power. Just where exactly is the value in this?
Well, the value in quantum computing is currently directly linked to hardware development. That's because it's the hardware that lets you run all these wonderful and fantastic quantum algorithms that are, you know, going to give you those speed ups and benefits over normal computers. Hardware like processor chips, right? But to get to a functional chip, you need to build qubit control architecture.
So as far as the update out this week, Mohammad, you say you've been working on control. Why is this such a key milestone here?
Well, I mean, Andrew, to put it simply, without control, you have no chip. I mean, that means, you know, we need to design and build control architectures that can integrate with our qubit material. The qubit is the fundamental component in our processor. And these qubit control devices that Archer are building are really state of the art.
And you've been using specialized software here as part of the process. Just tell us a bit more about this.
Yeah, I mean, look, I guess I just want to turn that around. We are using specialized software that you find in the semiconductor industry to model and to, you know, build these devices. Really, if we're not using this type of software at this stage of our development, I think you'd be right to ask me with a little bit of skepticism, you know, questions regarding our progress. But I think the fact that we are using this type of software and, you know, successfully, you know, building these qubit control devices, testing them with scalability in mind, means, you know, really what you're seeing is a leading indicator of success towards qubit control of few and single qubits. Now, Andrew, we're not going into this blind, right? We have shown that we're able to control large amounts of qubits that will be used in our 1-2-CQ chip. You know, this was done a few years ago. And really what it's about now and the focus now is about qubit control on the few and single qubit level. Now that we've been able to successfully, you know, isolate and miniaturize our qubits onto, you know, substrates like silicon. And this has never been done before. This is a world first.
So this really is state-of-the-art stuff here, Mohammad. You've had to essentially start from scratch as part of the development process.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, what we do is deep tech and there's no answer off the shelf. You can't Google this stuff, right? So there's an incredible, amount of IP that goes into building these devices. And, you know, qubit control is absolutely fundamental to the operation of our chip.
So tell us a bit more, Mohammad. What's next in the development pipeline here?
Yeah, so we are, you know, iterating on different types of qubit control architectures. Remember, this is very, very complex electronics, very complex physics, quantum mechanics and quantum physics. And, you know, to us, it's a seemingly normal part of development that we iterate and we advance and we build more complex devices that ultimately we're looking to, you know, integrate a control device with our qubit. And that's something that's absolutely exciting and very much looking forward to updating you on.
Good to see you, Mohammad. As always, thanks very much.
Thanks for having me.